2 of our shred, I'm going over this week on how to do proper form on pretty typical exercises. I hope you'll pick up a few tips. Everything I'm doing is a giant set or superset, so I want you to do it each exercise in order 3 times. So you'll be doing 9 sets, women 10 to 12, men 8 to 10, guys put as much weight as you can, women put as much weight as you can, but not a lot on the flies. Okay, guys, the heaviest I would advise is 30 pounds. I know guys out there doing 80 pounds, 100 pound flies. You're asking for trouble. You really are. There's no use, no reason to do that. Okay, most people that get to the gym, they do a fly, they put the 2 dumbbells up on top, and they go as wide as they can, and they pull them back together. That's wrong. You're gonna hurt your shoulder. What I want you to do is go as high as you can, then drop it down to where it's about a foot over your, foot and a half foot over your body, and your elbows are straight out, and your hands are together, touching. I am making a diamond in this area right here. I'm gonna drop my weights down in the form of a W if I was looking straight into the mirror. Okay, so I'm going from diamond to W, back and forth for my flies. And the weights, when they come together, is over my chest. It's not over my shoulders. So I'm gonna go 12 reps like that. Okay, when I'm done, I'm gonna go straight in to a static one-arm bicep press. One-arm static chest press. I don't know why I said bicep. Anyway, both hands up together, touching, and one arm only goes up and down. Anytime you have 2 hands with the weights in them, one's moving and one is staying the same, that's called static. You do this on bicep curls and all kinds of things. And then I'm gonna do 10 on the other side once I've done the first 10. Okay, so one arm is straight, one arm is static, and the other arm is going up and down to it. When you're done, put them together, down to your chest, and then sit up. That's the proper way to get out of anything. Never leave an exercise with your arms out here and then just drop them. Okay, you always, wherever they're at, come into your body and then sit up straight. Okay, those are your first 2 exercises. Your third exercise is a simple squat. So I'm gonna have a kettlebell. I'm gonna hold it in goblet style. So I'm gonna hold the handles. I just kind of tuck my hand, my thumbs around the base, hold it, put my fingers in front, and then my toes are gonna be pointing out. My knees are gonna go out over my toes, and I'm gonna go down as far as my butt goes down, as far as my knees are, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and do these squats. I'm not gonna dilly-dally about it. I'm gonna do 15 squats. That's the third exercise of our set. I'm keeping this kettlebell nice and close to my body. Okay, you can hold it like this if it's really heavy and you can't hold it on top, but I prefer to hold it here because I'm also getting a workout on my bicep. Okay, if you can hold it here, it works good. If you can't, then just hold it down below you like that, all right? So, your exercise this time is incline, because we're gonna work the top of our chest. Dumbbell flies, supersetted with one arm, static dumbbell chest press. And then I'm adding, to make it a giant set, the kettlebell sumo squats. Okay, so do that whole exercise 3 times. Add it to something else you like that I've done on my YouTube channel, and you'll have a really great workout, okay? See you guys tomorrow.